Right here on Pinehurst Street in the historic Belhaven neighborhood of Jackson, Mississippi, lies a house and garden named after a literary icon.
This is where she wrote her short stories, her novels.
Eudora Welty earned several awards for her literary work, including a Pulitzer Prize for her novel, The Optimist's Daughter, which centers around a young woman who has left the South and returns, years later, to New Orleans, where her father is dying. She's published over 15 books, but Welty was also an acclaimed photographer, thanks to her dad.
He gave her her first camera, and so it was a way of capturing the world around her. So she was an excellent observer, and you can tell that in her fiction and the way she listens to dialogue and is able to replicate that on the page.
When you come to the Visitor Center, which used to be Welty's neighbor's house, you can see some of her photos, but that's not all.
We have exhibits about her family, her inspirations. We also have a display case of her literary awards. She never displayed those in the house, so we have them on display here. We have artifacts from her upbringing, her father's pocket watch that she writes about in her memoir.
Right now, there's also a special exhibit titled A Parade of Blooms, Stories from the Welty Garden. It explores how gardening brought the Welty family together, strengthened Eudora Welty's friendships, and inspired several of her stories. Speaking of a garden, you can also take a tour of that. It's located behind Welty's home and is inspired by Welty's mother, Justina, who was an avid gardener.
She designed all of the garden beds that you see around the home. So we call the garden our living exhibit because really it is historic. The plants are historic artifacts that are just living and growing, and we have to tend to them. So Eudora and her mother work together out in the garden.
There are hundreds of varieties of plants to see in the garden. It's interpreted from the 1920s to the 1940s because that's when Eudora and her mother were gardening the most. There's even an audio tour you can enjoy while you look around.
It's narrated by Susan Haltom, who worked with Eudora to restore the garden, and Mary Alice Welty White, who is Eudora's niece.
Once you tour the visitor center and garden, then you can take a tour of the home Welty lived in. The house was built in 1925 and still features original furniture that Welty actually used.
She had two nieces, so she left all of the contents of her home to her nieces. They in turn donated almost everything back to the Department of Archives and History. And so we have a complete literary home, one of the most complete literary homes in the country.
You must reserve tickets to see the home, but both the visitor center and the garden are completely free. Rhodes says whether you're a fan of history or just love to read, this is a must-see when you come visit Jackson, Mississippi.
You'll learn about women writers during that time period. And so she inspired so many modern authors. So you really get to see that legacy.
Such a cool experience, everyone, and you get your stamp right here at the gift shop. And look, if you want to set up a wonderful tour here at the Eudora Welty House and Garden, to find out tour times and to purchase your tickets, head over to EudoraWeltyHouse.com. They're located at 1119 Pinehurst Street, right here in Jackson, Mississippi. And of course, you can always follow them on Instagram and Facebook at Eudora Welty House.